and I'm Creedy. We're going to be the host for this volleyball workout routine.
We recommend this routine for anyone who wants to start volleyball or is in currently playing volleyball.
This routine is going to be held outdoors and indoors.
Hey, can I prepare for this routine in advance?
Absolutely. Drink plenty of water, eat lots of healthy food, and make sure you have your meal 1 to 2 hours before you start this workout routine.
We also recommend doing the routine in the order that we say, otherwise you might get fatigued or hurt yourself. If you do feel fatigued, please take a break for a second or do the modifications we show you how to in the video. Let's get started! The materials for this workout that you'll need are volleyball or tennis shoes,
knee pads,
volleyball or workout attire,
volleyballs,
a towel,
a volleyball net,
and a partner. Start outside by warming up. Walk for 2 minutes, jog for 3 minutes after that. This gets your heart rate up and prepares your body, especially your heart, to start exercising.
Now we're gonna do arm stretches.
You're gonna put your arm across your chest and hold it with your other arm like this and count 1 to 10. Ready? Begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Now we're gonna switch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job. Now we're gonna do butt kicks, like this.
Now I'm gonna show you how to do Spider-Man's. You're gonna extend your leg like a lunge and keep your hand on the inside of your leg.
For this part of the warm-up, we're going to be doing ball count, like this.
You're going to do this action 10 times with your partner. Ready? Begin. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have now completed the whole warm-up.
In order to condition, you will need a volleyball net. If you don't have access to one, then draw a line on the ground. We're going to be working on increasing your vertical jump. Line up at the net or line, hold your hands up, your palms should be facing away from you. Prepare to jump and extend your hands up. Now jump and imagine a ball. You're trying to block this ball. Do this continually, shifting down the line as you do it. Repeat at least 3 times.
To modify this exercise, find a wall. Jump as high as you can in the same method described earlier. Do not injure yourself and do not push yourself too much. You need to face the wall and do short, quick jumps touching the wall each time. This will give you a similar benefit and improve your skills. However, if possible, do the original exercise.
Now we're going to be doing run-throughs. You're going to need knee pads, workout shoes, and a volleyball.
And a partner. One person will throw the ball. At targets, setter's position, also known as the center of the front of the court, your partner will throw the ball. You will start at a corner in the back. Your partner will throw the ball high to the opposite corner. Your job is to run and pass the ball back to the target. Repeat this action from both corners at the center of the backcourt 10 times each. This exercise helps you work on passing skills and increase your speed and agility.
Now we will do a spider drill. This will require knee pads. Move indoors and use a rectangular area. Start in the right-hand corner in the back of the area.
Run to the center. Now turn and dive to your right. Run back to the center. Take an approach to the net as demonstrated. Do the blocking exercise that was done earlier to the half point, assuming that you are gradually shifting to the left. At this point, you should be in the center of the front of the court. Go back to the center in the middle of the court. Now run forward to your left in the corner in a diagonal line. Pretend as if you are passing a ball thrown to you. Turn back to the center and dive left. Go back to the center and run to the back left hand of the court and cover a ball tipped to you. Return to the center. Turn 180 degrees and dive. You should end up in the center of the back of the court or area that you are using. Repeat this entire exercise twice, demonstrated by Megan.
This is our last exercise called the pit. You will need to find an indoor court area. You will need knee pads, a volleyball net, and volleyballs. Don't forget a partner. This exercise will test your defensive skills on the court. Here's how you do it. Position yourself in the center of the court. Your partner should be at target. They will have the volleyballs. You need to start in the center of the back side of the court. Your partner will throw the balls long and short in different areas of the court. Your job is to touch each one and attempt to get a hand on it. It doesn't have to be a good touch, just make contact between the ball and your hand before it touches the ground. Please watch Megan for the demonstration. To modify this, if you cannot dig a ball that is hit at you, then inform your partner and tell him or her to only throw long or short.
Again, we want you to run and jog outside, but this time only jog for 2 minutes and walk for one. Now we're going to do the cool down section of our video. First, we're going to touch our toes. Ready? Begin.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Now right over left.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
And left over right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Now we're going to be doing push-up squats for 30 seconds. Do as many as you can and make sure you follow this form. When you squat down, make sure your knees don't pass your toes. That's really important to get the full benefits of the exercise.
Ready? Begin. 1. Now we're going to show you how to do planks, and we're going to do them as long as we can for 30 seconds. Katie will now get on the ground, and she will lay on her forearms like this, and she's going to have a straight back for the full benefit of the exercise. This strengthens your core and your arm muscles. So now we're going to do a plank on her back. So lift up, and she is completely off the ground. This will help you again with your abs and your forearms. Thanks for watching our video.
If you need to do any other exercises, then please do so.
And good luck on the court.